Good afternoon, members. It is the scheduled time and the quorum is present. Welcome to the meeting of the panel on House Affairs, Home Affairs on the 13th. Item 1, information papers issued since the last meeting. That is LC paper number CB4374. That is the administration's response dated the 11th of May to Dr. David Lam's letter on the anti-epidemic support scheme for environmental hygiene and security staff. Item 2, items for discussion at the next meeting. There are two papers for this item. The next regular meeting will be held between 4:30 p.m. and 6:30 p.m. on the 11th of July. There are two items proposed by the administration. That is the cultural projects and the community hall at Sai Yi Street, Mong Kok. If there's no objection, then those will be the items at the next meeting. Item 3, agenda proper. Let's invite the representative of the Home Affairs Bureau as well as the WKCDA members to join us. Welcome. Today we have Mr. Jack Chan, Acting Secretary for Home Affairs, and also from the West Kowloon Cultural District Authority, or WKCDA. We have Mr. Henry Tang, the Board Chairman, and Mrs. Betty Fung, Chief Executive Officer, and the Museum Director of the Hong Kong Palace Museum, Dr. Louis. Welcome. Item 3, updates on the progress of the West Kowloon Cultural District, WKCD development and implementation of infrastructure works for WKCD Phase 1 4th construction package. LC paper number CB2417/2022-3 and 4. I remind members concerning the public works proposal involved in the item, it is in accordance with the rules of procedures 83A. If you have any direct or indirect pecuniary interest concerning the item we are dealing with today, please disclose the nature of such interest before you speak. Now, please press the button if you want to speak. Now, ready when you are, Mr. Jack Chan and Mr. Henry Tang, the acting secretary, will give us a briefing, and then Mr. Henry Tang. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, members. Today, I will submit two papers to the panel. First, updates of the progress of the WKCD prepared by the Home Affairs Bureau and the WKCDA. The WKCD is a strategic investment by the Hong Kong SAR government to support and promote arts and culture development. With years of planning and development, the major facilities of the WKCD, including a CG center, free space, and arts park, have been launched since 2019. M+ was also launched last November, and it is well received by the public. Now, it was announced last week that the highly anticipated Hong Kong Palace Museum will be opened next week. It is a important activities to mark the 25th anniversary for the reunification of Hong Kong with the mainland. It is a very unique area, the WKCD, and also the National 14th Five-Year Plan supports Hong Kong to be a East Meets West International Cultural Exchange Center. WKCD can contribute significantly to the nation's development. We would like to seek members' support to promote, to implement the Phase 1 4th construction package of the WKCD, including the south landing facilities and also improvements of sea barriers, as well as drainage and water supply system, as well as road enhancements and beautification work. Subject to members' support, the Home Affairs Bureau will submit the detailed funding proposal to the Public Works Subcommittee, as well as the Finance Committee for approval. Now I will invite Mr. Henry Tang, the chairman of the board of the WKCDA, to give us an update of the WKCD in the past year. Thank you, Chairman. Good afternoon, members. Today I'm pleased to report to the panel of Home Affairs. I'm happy to meet the first term of Legislative Council members after the improvement of the electoral system after the implementation of Patriots administering Hong Kong. Now, I would like to talk about some history. That is the original vision for the WKCD and the original roadmap. In year 2008, we established the, when we legislated for the West Kowloon Cultural District Ordinance, I was the Chief Secretary for Administration. I strongly felt that Hong Kong has transformed from a tiny fishing village to a manufacturing center, and then we had the maritime sector, and then we had trade and commerce, and then onwards we had financial services and high-end professional services. What will be our next stage of development? Well, for the next stage, a lot of Hong Kong people would like to enjoy the free time at leisure facilities and cultural areas, so that the entire family can enjoy this place called Hong Kong, which is their home. Now, with 40 hectares size, WKCD is a very scarce resource. It has a full view to the harbor, and it is located right in the center of the urban area. So we want to let Hong Kong people know that WKCD is part of their home, and this will be the focus of culture and arts in the future. It will be fully open up for pedestrians. I think this is the first time ever in the world that we have such a large pedestrian zone. When you drive by the area, when you are chatting, and when you are, or even when you are dozing off, you won't get to see the, you don't get to enjoy the scenery a lot. But if you're walking on foot, you will be able to feel the beauty, enjoy the beauty of the area and the view of the Victoria Harbour. So that's our original vision. The future is about culture, arts, innovation, technology, and leisure. A lot of our new facilities are built on that premises. Under the National 14-5-year plan, with all our hardware, we now have the support of the nation for us to become an East Meet West International Cultural Exchange Center. We have the software and hardware as well as the support of the nation. And I'm confident that we can realize our vision. Back in 2008, the LegCo approved $21.6 billion in funding for us to implement the project. I was the first chairman of the WKCDA. I said early on that the $21.6 billion was not sufficient for building all the facilities. That estimate was made right after SARS, and it was a long time ago. In terms of inflation, building cost, and investment return, the forecast was based on outdated figure. We didn't come back to LegCo to tell them we are going to go bankrupt, because the LegCo said we had so much money. We had $21.6 billion. So why can't you take forward your project? So we didn't tell the LegCo back then. Our financial philosophy was build as we go. A lot of arts and cultural facilities cannot support the operation on their own. We need to have support from the government. And also, the money has to come from our retail, dining, leisure, and commercial tenants. is how the WKCDA have the funding to subsidize our arts and culture facilities. This is a unique model globally, and it is a sustainable development model. For this model, we have to build as we go. It means that when we have a building item, we have to have a money-earning item. So that's how we proceed with our plan. With that plan, we can make the $21.6 billion endowment fund last with more facilities built. So I think the previous two terms of the Legislative Council members would have heard that we have a serious mismatch of cash flow. Our site was loaned to the high-speed rail, and it has been 12 years. Originally, we were supposed to get our site back in 5 years. In the end, it was much longer than that, and it was fatal for our cash flow. During the 7 years when the site was loaned to the high-speed rail, that's where most of our money-earning projects are. So we have to build the basement before we can have the pedestrian zone at ground. Otherwise, we can't facilitate access for fire services, delivery, and so on. So the entire project has been delayed for 7 years. Most of the major components, including loon rigs, free space, and the Palace Museum, are on the west. So we couldn't fulfill the build as we go model, and there was a serious mismatch of financial cash flow. In a moment, Betty will talk about our efforts in cutting expenditure and creating income stream. So I think if FTU uses our space to recruit members, you'll be very popular because we have a lot of employees who are underemployed. Their salaries have been frozen and they are working two jobs. So I hope you won't come to recruit union members at our site. So looking forward, how can we build more culture and arts facilities? But like I said, we have to come back to the governments for money. How we are going to do that, that's another story. Today, I will change my method. So that was before SARS. Before the COVID, the government hasn't spends the $500 or $600 billion on battling COVID. So before COVID, I could come to the government for money. After COVID, I don't want to do that. If I do that, that would be asking for the impossible. The current term or the next term of the government will have a lot of livelihood issues to deal with. There are going to be deep-rooted issues to address. Even if you can create a new landmass for building, it will cost a lot of money. So this is a bad time to come to the government for money because it would be diverting resources from livelihood issues. So we have to handle it ourselves before Besides cutting expenditure, we have to make best use of our only resources, that is land. So we will discuss with the government how we can better utilize our land resources to achieve a sustainable development so that in future we can be self-sufficient without asking the government for money nor competing for resources with livelihood issues. That would be the only responsible way to do it. So in a moment, Betty will give you the details.
Now, for the Palace Museum, it will open on 2nd of July. That will be open to the public. It will be open next week, in fact. Now, you've been there. You went there and you saw a building. Now, you can expect that with the exhibits in, it will be very attractive. Now, you take the only road to WKCD, and at the end, there's the Palace Museum. You will go past M+, the WKCDA building, and then at the very end, you come to the Hong Kong Palace Museum. So, at the West Kowloon Tunnel, there should be a road for people to go in, so that once you get in, the first place you come to is the Palace Museum. And right now, if you stand at Sichu Center and if you look at Palace Museum, it's a straight road, but you can't walk that along that road because the West Kowloon Tunnel cuts across that road. So we try to make a central access road for pedestrians from Sichu Center to the Hong Kong Palace Museum. So you can take that straight road and go direct. Now, last time you saw the red door of the Palace Museum and you can see the Sichu Center. In future, you can walk along a straight road. You will go past M+ or some retail and dining facilities. It's like walking along a main thoroughfare. So that will highlight the position and status of the Palace Museum. Now we are discussing that with the government. Now I won't tell you the details now, I can't, because it's still subject to discussion and we will have to do traffic impact assessment and so on. So we will communicate with the government, especially we will cooperate with the next term government. So I will stop here. Betty, CEO. Just now, the chairman gave a high-level introduction. He mentioned some structures of our development plan. In 2014, at the time the WKCDA chairman came to LegCo and said that $21.6 billion can only afford the first and second batches of cultural facilities. Which were those? Now, the first batch includes the Sichu Center, M+ Museum, the Free Space, Art Park, and so on. Now, the second batch, now there's the Lyric Theatre Complex, there's a 3-in-1 complex, Lyrics Theatre, a medium theatre, and a small theatre. And now, in 2016, we further announced the Palace Museum. And then there are some blue facilities. Now, the chairman said that we were short of resources. We didn't have the resources for them. We gave priority to the music centre near the Lyric Theatre Complex. The chairman expressed a wish to build the music centre. And the white one, Now, the chairman mentioned the commercial facilities. All the white structures are built upon the basement. So if we can't build the basement, we can't build the superstructures. Now, at 3B, Area 3B, we are building the Art Square Tower. We are building 138,000 square meters of retail facilities and over 33,000 square meters of cultural facilities. The chairman mentioned our progress after building the Lyric Theatre Complex. The cultural facilities will be completed. Now, as for the Hong Kong Palace Museum, starting tomorrow, we will formally sell the tickets. This time, we will not have to go over budget. That's a good record. This is a gift for the 25th reunification anniversary, and nearly 200 museum exhibits. Now, 768 will be in Museum 1. 166 Grade 1 exhibits will be in Halls 1 to 5. And then Halls 8 to 9, they are for the special exhibits. Now, every 30, 60 months, we change to some other exhibits. But apart from the $50 ticket, we have a half-price ticket that's $25 for full-time students, children, elderly people over 16, handicapped, those on CSSA. For those under 6, it's free. We have also a membership system. To celebrate the reunification, we have free Wednesday visits in the first few months. Over a whole year, we expect that there will be 360,000 people who can benefit from the free Wednesday visits. And also, we have obtained sponsorship, sufficient sponsorship to buy 150,000 tickets to be distributed to the disadvantaged groups. We have also 14,000 students who can join freely. Now, including the 360,000 free Wednesday visits, there will be about 254,000 visits in the first year, about 35% of the total tickets. We will try to get more resources for free tickets. Now, as for the ticket arrangement for the Palace Museum, we will issue a press release tomorrow at 10 a.m. We will formally sell the tickets. We will sell the tickets for the first 4 months, including the months for the Wednesday. There will be about 140,000 tickets for sale tomorrow and for booking. There will be a central ticketing platform. 80% will be available, first come, first served. Four tickets per person, that's the limit. Now, you can use the Palace Museum app, the WKCD app, and so on. And we can also get the tickets from our ticket office. Now, this is the Lyric Theatre Complex. There are three facilities there. Now, and then you see the progress of our works. Now, you can see where the theatres are going to appear. Now, the foundation is already completed, and the basement is also completed. We are now at the second story of the Lyric Theatre Complex. We expect by 2024 we can complete this major initiative. Now, there will be a large integrated basement. It's about 200,000 square meters. So it is built by phases, 2A, 2B, and 2C together make up phase 2. Now, zone 2. Now, we also carry out the foundation works for zone. Now, The foundation works to 2B and 2C last July, and we expect that the foundation works will be completed by the end of next year. Now, many members are concerned about the connectivity of WKCD. In the past, there was no direct approach. Now, since 2019, we opened the museum road. Cars can come through the museum road. And last March, March last year, there was also approach from Austin Road. And then we also opened the Art Square footbridge, and you can get there in a few minutes. And then the chairman mentioned that there will be new exit road. This is from the West Kowloon Expressway. They can come directly into WKCD. It's U-shaped. We are going to talk with the government on the ideal on the alignment. And then there is the landing facility. Now, this is very important. Right now, there might be traffic jam. You have to go through the roundabout. Now, with the landing facility, now people in future can take the water taxi from Central. It only take a very short time from Central. And then the last part is we are going to build one more footbridge connecting Zone 2A with the Kowloon Park. Right now, it's fire services site, so we can't start the work yet. Now, as for operations, now impacted by COVID over the past couple of years, had to close a number of facilities, and we had to cancel some activities, but we used virtual programs to enable the public to participate. So you can refer to our document B. Now, after the premises are reopened, we have a high usage rate, 74% for the Shichu Center, Grand Theater, and Free Space, that's 80%. And the Art Park is even more popular. Over weekends, every day, over 10,000 people come to the park for leisure. And we make use of the park to work with Trade Development Council, Hong Kong Philharmonic Orchestra, etc., to organize many activities. As for M+, it was opened 12th of November last year. And then in January, we closed it temporarily for over 3 months. And as of yesterday, there have been over 800,000 visits to the M+. So that shows it's very popular. After the reopening, we opened two cinemas last year, 186 and 140. And then in the first round, we will have over 70 movies. We will have the some 4K versions of old films. Now, as for cultural software, you can look at NXD. Because apart from software, apart from hardware, we have to use hardware to cultivate local artistic talent so that they can perform in WKCD to show forth their skills. Now, as for M+ and the Palace Museum, we have a very popular lecture series on the Palace Museum. There have been 9 sessions, over 4,000 participants. And then I'd like to talk about financial situation. The chairman mentioned our structural problem. That is, there's a mismatch between our revenue and expenditure. This is unavoidable because the huge basement causes a delay in the construction. But we tried to expedite the commercial developments. In November last year, we put out the tender for the Art Square Tower.
Now, in year 2021, excluding our investments and returns, That is the $6 billion that we have withdrawn from the HKMA. Now, the excluding that, the operating income was down by close to 60%. At the beginning of year 2021, we expected the boundary to be reopened soon, but that didn't happen. So the venues remained closed. So the income has dropped to less to $100 million. And also, we have compressed expenditure. So that the operating loss was reduced from the $1.1 billion reported to the LegCo to $780 million. So despite the reduced income, we have also cut expenditure and cut down the loss. So the $21.6 billion plus interest will run out next year. At this difficult time, thanks to the approval given by the Financial Secretary, we were able to expand our financial facilities and to secure a $4 billion loan, including a $1 billion term loan and $3 billion revolving credits to be drawn down as and when necessary. Now, we are going to have interest rate increase cycle, so we will be very careful in taking out more loans. Now, for the financial situation over the coming 3 years, after the drastic reduction of expenditure, for the past three financial years, we have cut down 25% of our operating costs, that is some $1.25 billion. We will be able to cut $300 million in terms of operating costs for the next 3 years, but that is the best we can do because we are maintaining a skeleton model of operation. If we want to develop our facilities, we have to add more manpower. Now, by year 2024 to 2025, the establishment is 840. It is even fewer than 812, which we have reported last year. Like the chairman said, many employees are working two jobs. They are very enthusiastic people. They are passionate about arts. That's why they chose to stay and work with us. For the way forward, we will not abandon our vision to promote arts and culture. We will work with the Tourism Board as well as the Culture, Sports and Tourism Board in the next term of the government to promote WKCD to foreign visitors. And we support the HKSL government to promote Hong Kong as an East meets West international exchange hub under the 14th Five-Year Plan. Now, I defer to the CEDD colleagues. Please be brief. Now I will brief members on the Phase 1 fourth construction package of the WKCD through some PowerPoint slides. The fourth construction package includes the area in red, that is the South Landing facility, and also for the area dotted in red, we will supply water and implement drainage and sewage systems for Zone 2. Now, for the Southern Landing facility, it is near the Arts Park to the west. After the construction, for those who arrives at sea can walk to M+, the Lunar Theatre Complex, and other retail and dining facilities. The landing facility will be opened to public vessels and also pre-book routes for events. It will also be a landing point for water taxis to further improve the accessibility for WKCD. It is near the China ferry pier route, so we have to implement effective control to ensure maritime safety. For public vessels using the facility, they will have to register with us first. The WKCDA will be responsible for the management and operation of the Southern Landing facility. It is 60 meters long and 20 meters wide with elevated platforms and universal accessibility ramp for passengers. The project also includes installation of water supply, drainage and sewage systems for Zone 2. It is some 20 hectares in size, and there will be retail, dining and commercial functions on the ground level. We have to install water supply, drainage and sewage systems to tie in with the development. Estimated capital cost at money of the day prices, it is about $425.1 million. Now, southern landing facility and seawall modification will cost $147.8 million. For infrastructure, it is about $121.3 million. Associated landscaping, road and other ancillary works will cost $74.9 million. Other expenses, including entrustment fee, consultancies fees, remuneration for resident site staff, and environmental mitigation measures, will cost $42.7 million. The proposed works will commence after the approval by FC and will complete within 7 years. Subject to funding approval, we can commence work in the third phase this year and complete it by year 2025. We plan to seek funding approval from the Financial Committee after consulting the Public Works Committee. Thank you. Once again, we thank Mr. Harry Tang, Betty, and the CDD colleagues. We also have to thank the WKCDA for arranging a visit for us last month, which would surely contribute to our discussion today. So we have 14 members. We have to keep the time strictly. So we are talking about the WKCD progress and the funding approval for infrastructure works. So I will give each of the members 3 minutes. First, Jovi Chen. Thank you, Chair. The Palace Museum has been a long time coming. On the second day of the 25th anniversary of the reunification of Hong Kong with the nation, it will be opened and will contribute significantly to our role as a East-West center under the National 5-Year Plan. However, there is a charge. The full fee is $120. It is more expensive than the museum at Beijing and Taipei. Now, the Jockey Club has made donation to build the Palace Museum. There are still $260 million left. So can we subsidize the entrance fee with this amount of money and waive the fee? And for the Beijing Palace Museum, the fee is flexible. So for certain parts of the museum at the peak seasons, it costs $80 RMB or $94 Hong Kong. At non-peak seasons, it will only charge $60 RMB or $70 Hong Kong. So it is a flexible structure for the Palace Museum in Beijing. So my second question is, if we are to charge a fee, would you make reference to the model of the Beijing Palace Museum and make it flexible? So the fee is not extraordinarily high. However, compared with M Plus, which is just next door, after launching in last November, the entrance fee is waived for a full year. So why is there different models? So your explanation is the exhibit items in Palace Museum are very expensive with a high maintenance cost. So even if you are charging entrance fee, it will only cover one third of the cost. So for M Plus exhibits, we have a hard time understanding those items. Some are explicit and some are not suitable for children. But you are not charging for M Plus, and maybe the maintenance fee is low. So why are we spending public money to acquire these items? So that is my query. I remind members, we have 14 members waiting, so I hope we can comply strictly with the 3-minute time limit to allow the administration to respond. Chairman, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Jovi Chen. I will take the question. It involves M Plus and the overall charging model. Concerning the donation from Jockey Club, the $3.5 million. It was as for construction fee. As we know, Jockey Club does not subsidize the operating cost of other institution. So Jockey Club is willing to leave behind the $260 million, but it's specified that the purpose will not be for operation, but rather subsidizing exhibition and activities. Concerning peak and non-peak seasons, like I've explained on other platforms, there is one universal charge for the Beijing Palace Museum. In Hong Kong, it is more difficult for us to make a distinction between peak and non-peak season. In Beijing, it is easier. In winter times, it is very cold, so people don't tend to visit museums during winter times. So that is why there is a non-peak season charge to encourage visitors. Now, in Hong Kong, the museum is opened all year round, so it is more difficult to make a distinction between peak and non-peak season. We have made reference to the Beijing Palace Museum for the basic fee. Our fee is cheaper than the Beijing. In Beijing, they don't have a regular exhibition, but we do. For special exhibition, we would charge a separate fee. For museums overseas, for special exhibition, they would charge a high price. Every year, we would have a different special exhibitions. If we are not charging for our special exhibitions, it would pose extraordinary pressure on us because we have to spend tens of billions of dollars on each of them. For M+, the $21.6 billion endowment fee covered the operation and building of M+, so it is covered, and also we have received a lot of contribution. So in year 2019, we decided to open M+ for free for 1 year to thank the Hong Kong public for funding the construction of M+. Well, if you look at our financial condition, if we offer free entrance for Palace Museum, we will not be able to sustain, because by year 2023, the endowment fund would have run out. Now, for Palace Museum, we are borrowing every single piece of the exhibit items. We have to pay for the logistic, delivery, and insurance costs. It took $100 million. That is one-third of our operating costs for the next 3 years. Director? Well, $15 million is spent on exhibition-related activities, and some $100 million will be spent on maintaining all the exhibits in Palace Museum, including insurance, exhibition, and logistics. And we have to thank Jockey Club for leaving the remaining sum with us, which involved some $190 million per year. So entrance tickets will contribute some $100 million to our income every year. It will contribute to our quality of service. Now, some 30% of the entrance tickets will be given to the public for free. So there is a balance. Thank you. Ms. Rebecca Chen. Thank you, Chair. For WKCD to become an international culture hub, I think we have to build our own talent pool. So I'm concerned about talent training. So you gave us some figures on the paper. Now, through multiple schemes, the M+ is building a talent pool. For year 2021 and 2022, M+ has only recruited 10 interns. So there are a lot of programs. It includes curating management of exhibits and so on. But only a small number of recruits of interns are recruited. So is it because of the cuts of expenditure, or is it because of the epidemic? With such marvelous hardware, we have to train the talents to man them. Second, I thank Mr. Vincent Chen, the chairman, for arranging a visit, arrange meetings between us and some small to medium artistic groups. They told us that they couldn't afford the rent, especially in the WKCD. On the paper, you mentioned that in year 2024, you would arts, the Lyrics Theatre Complex would be completed with three theatres with different number of seatings. So after the Lyrics Theatre Complex is completed, I know you are running on a self-financing basis. But can you offer rental concessions to arts groups in Hong Kong so that they can use the Lyrics Theatre Complex? Thank you.
I thank Ms. Rebecca Chen for the questions. Now, for interns at the M+, it's a very long-term program. Every intern will practice for 1 year at M+. It's very in-depth. In 2020 to 21, M+ was not yet open, so we took on 10 interns. Now, 21, 22, and 2023, the number will increase to about 15. Now, for the Palace Museum, it will have its own internships. We will also have summer interns. So that's for 2 to 3 months. They will go to different departments and learn about the work there. Now, for M+ interns, as member said, if our resources permit, we will take on more because it's a very popular program. Now, as for the Lyric Theatre Complex, there are three venues. For the medium theatre and the larger theatre, the target were for two of the theatres, we target the medium and small theatre troops. So we will certainly offer favourable rents. Now, there will be subsidies involved. If it's a theatre performance, we subsidize almost half of the rent. Now, some people say that the LCSD venues are cheaper, but we offer subsidies. So I think 10 to 15 interns is still a small number. I hope that you don't lag behind on talent cultivation just because you want to be able to self-finance. Next, Rock Chen. Just now, Mr. Tang Ying Yan is right. The WKCD will stimulate the Hong Kong as a place of interchange for East and West, cultural exchange, but the pandemic will pass. In the future, we will cooperate with international museums and performance groups. What kind of activities will we have? And by 2024 to 2025, the operational deficit will still exceed $1 billion. So from your current estimate, when will you have a balanced cash flow? When will you in fact show a profit? Now, internationally, please be assured, now the WKCD's positioning is a world-class cultural facility. We compare with the top-notch museums, and we will work with top performance groups. The Palace Museum will be have a in a partnership relationship with over 70 overseas institutions. So we don't just work with the Beijing Palace Museum, but with museums in other cities in the mainland. Now, our performance groups are also many of the officers are members of major international organizations. Now, as for financial situation. We have already built a large quantity of cultural facilities. No cultural city in the world can be self-sufficient. Museums abroad also rely on diverse other sources of funding. Now, the director is very competent. He has obtained a lot of sponsorship. However, being self-sufficient is difficult. So as the chairman said, we will have to rely on our land resources in the long term so that we can add value and enhance our cash flows. So we are working with our financial director. The land is very precious. We have a full sea view. We have to make good use of it. That's our challenge. Next, Ms. Chen Yitming. Now, I'm glad to hear that the Palace Museum will open next month. And so we have M+, free space, and so on. So that will be a very good basis. Now, I'd like to ask about the admission arrangements. Now, there is a admission fee system, and the Palace Museum is to enhance people's appreciation and understanding of Chinese culture and also cultivate national identity. Now, Hong Kong education lagged behind in this regard in the past. So I think this is a mission of the Hong Kong Palace Museum. So I think there should be policies to encourage public admission, especially the students of tertiary, secondary, and primary schools. Now, will there be free admission places for schools to apply for? There should be guided tours. Now, to encourage admission, will WKCD, like theme parks, offer free admission on birthdays or charitably funded admission for elderly people? Many museums offer free admission for those over 60. Now, this will increase the financial burden of WKCD, but I think it's very reasonable. And I think we can have make up for this by admission fees from visiting tourists. The speaker is not speaking through the mic. Now, international cultural exchange is a very important point. For WKCD, it also has to increase people's understanding of our Chinese culture. This is especially for the schools. Now, for the students, we charge half fee, $25, and we are getting a lot of sponsorship. We expect that in future, through the sponsorship mechanisms, many students will visit free. Now, we are trying to get more sponsorship. In the future, we will announce the free places each year. We expect it will be significant. Now, apart from visiting exhibitions, there will be a large education center for students to visit. There will be workshops, and schools can organize activities in there. We will bring our cultural history knowledge to schools. We will support the schools in their curriculum. And we're working with the Education Bureau. And there will be education kits on artifacts restoration and so on. So we try to enhance the WKCD and and the Palace Museum's roles in this regard. I'd like to Mr. Kenneth Falk. Now, I am a member of the board, and for item 4 of the document, there is a matter of pecuniary interest. Now, the document told us about the initial conception of WKCD. It will be very important for our confidence in the Chinese culture, our social responsibility. Now, I agree with the importance of nurturing talent. Now, I know that Betty has tried hard to control cost, but paragraph 43 of the document mentions that for the cultural sector, as a representative of that sector, the quality of the program. The love of culture has to be in balance with finances. Now, salaries have been frozen for 2 years, so that has been a blow to the spirit of working spirit of workers. If people leave their jobs, then we will lose talent. Now, under 14th five-year plan, now, for cultural exchanges, we require a lot of local talent. The Palace Museum is just one of the projects involved in the years to come. Now, we talked about internship. Now, I also engaged in youth cultural exchanges with the mainland. Now, I know that the Home Affairs Bureau has a budget. It works with Cyberport. There will be local internships with the Cyberport. Now, maybe you can extend that to the cultural sector. We try to attract more people to the sector. Now, members ask about membership admission fees. Now, we don't just compare with museums related to the Palace Museum, but I think the amount is reasonable on international comparison. Now, for Paris, they have a Paris Pass. You buy the Paris Pass, you can visit many facilities, including some private facilities. So in the future, the WKCD, LCSD venues and private museums, perhaps there can be coordination by the government for a synergistic effect. So this will benefit both local and international tourists. Now, the same goes for admission fees. Finally, about the pier. Now, some people tell me that it's very expensive, $147 million. Now, of course, the water taxi concept is good, but the patronage last year was only about 3,500 last year. So with the pier, how to attract people to use water taxis, that's the issue. I try to be more succinct. Let me respond briefly on a few points. I thank Mr. Falk for his question. Firstly, I agree that with several members on the talent issue. Now, as a cultural center, I think hardware, software, and the audience are all important. The hardware, of course, we need more venues and exhibits. And as for software, that involves training of our talents, including cultural talent, management talent, as well as exchanges of talents in the future.
In fact, we also have to nurture an audience base. even if you have world-class hardware culture, hardware and software, if you lack the audienceship, it would be a tragedy. So we have to nurture both audience and talents. It all revolves around education. We have to nurture cultural awareness among young people, as well as an interest in culture among old and young people. They may be interested in Cantonese opera, but they don't know Qin opera. Then we have to educate them. If I like conventional art, but not contemporary art, maybe we have to educate them to like contemporary art as well. So I very much agree that training of talent is one of our three major directions when the WKCDA was created. So for arts and culture facilities, education is always a key directive. However, we lack money now. Even if we want to do more, I don't have the conditions to make it happen. So if you ask about my regrets, well, my regrets are that I don't have sufficient money to engage in education. My second regret is that I don't have the money to allow more local performance talents to reach out to a local audience at the WKCD. It's also because I don't have money. So I hope that besides relying on ourselves financially, we can do more than just make do and nurture more talents with our resources. So just now, the Vice Chairman mentioned about the landing facility. That is very important for the traffic of WKCD. People from all around the territories can be brought to the WKCD, and the cost is not exorbitant at all. Compared with another landing facility, that is the public pier at Lei Yu Mun, which was approved by the electrical lately, it costs some $140 million as well. So it is on the same level with our landing facility in WKCD. Let's not forget that this is going to be an iconic pier. It will be a pier with taste. So $140 million is not expensive at all. Mr. Ma Fong Kwok, Chair, I declare that I have been a director at the Board of Director of the WKCDA in the first 10 years. I have left the WKCD for WKCDA for several years, and now the CG Center is completed. Now, before the coming into office of this term of the CEO, for the two previous deficits, they have been telling us that they were in short of money in the first meeting. So that is not news. That is something that situation existed a decade ago. So the WKCDA and the board is aware of that. Now the it has been some tough years. You have compressed the loss to some $100 million. So you have cut the loss by some $300 million. So you have done a good job. Several years ago, we had a debate at the Legco about the WKCD. At the time, I was still a director. I suggested that we should not reduce the size of the development. We should not. There should be no delay. We should not be extravagant, and we should make no waste in our development. So now, after the first year of the new CEO's tenure, you have compressed the loss by $100 million. So what does that tell us? Does it mean that there have been problems with previous CEOs? Or is it because that we have more facilities launching these 2 years that we are able to cut the loss? But still, we had a severe epidemic and we had a lot of closure days. Still, we are able to cut the loss. I think the experience would be very important for future operation of the WKCD. So I wonder what can we learn from the experience. Mr. Mafung Kwok, thank you so much for your comments. 10 years ago, I was the Permanent Secretary for Home Affairs. It is very difficult for us to compress, to cut the loss. Two museums are opened. At the same time, it is the worst time for the WKCDA because we have run out of money. So for the past year, we have adopted a new financial model. Previously, we had a down-top model. That is, the departments would submit their financial proposals and the WKCDA would make cuttings here and there. This year, we have adopted a top-down model. That is, I would allocate a budget for Palace Museum, performance venues, and so on. And you have to sustain operation with that amount of money. For example, for Palace Museum, I can only allocate 45% of their operational cost, and they have to come up with the remaining 55% of operating costs. It creates a huge incentive for them to find contributions and sponsorship. Is it painful? Yes, it is very painful. So like Mr. Mafung Kwok said, if you would understand it if you are a director as the board. Board members are under huge pressure. So I always said all the directors as the board are passionate. They have suffered pay freeze for 2 years and they have to and they are under huge pressure to secure a sponsorship, but still they choose to stay. So we have adopted a top-down model and set a figure for the different facilities. So they have to come up with the remaining funds. But I stress that this is a one-off measure. If we continue to cut the cost for WKCD, it would be unfavorable for development. It takes time to nurture talents and build facilities. With the launching of M Plus and Palace Museum, we are starting a culture. We have got a lot of contribution and sponsors from a lot of institutions. So I hope that this culture will sustain. Thank you. Next, Mr. Johnny Ng. Chair, I'm happy to see that the WKCD has come this far. And I'm happy that it is in line with the national, the 14th National 5-Year Plan's role of Hong Kong, that is an East meets West cultural exchange hub. Now, we have borrowed a lot of exhibits from the mainland to attract visitations. So my question is that we have a lot of collectors in Hong Kong. They are local collectors. I've heard many collectors are willing, are eager to put their collections forward for exhibition, but they lack the opportunities. I think there are lots of collaboration opportunities between WKCD and our local collectors. So maybe they can loan out their treasures to increase the attractions of our museums. And also I agree with collaboration with schools. We should give out more free tickets to students to nurture their patriotism and also help the national education. So would you also consider collaborating with schools in GBA cities in the mainland. We have experienced, we have come through much in the past few years. We should enhance the bonding with our sister cities. So maybe we can explore more collaborations with GBA city schools. Mr. Henry Tang, thank you. I thank Mr. Johnny Ng for your, Dr. Johnny Ng for your suggestion. We have a lot of extraordinary collectors in Hong Kong. Their collection can be the a main attraction in any museums in the world. In my friend's home, I have come across extraordinary pieces of collections. I knew nothing about them, but after their explanation, I came to know how valuable those collections are. So the director, the museum director, Dr. Louis Ng, has secured a lot of exhibits for exhibition in the Palace Museum. So we have to give our heartfelt thanks to these collectors for their generosity. You are right, a lot of collectors have even more valuable collections. They are hesitant at donating the collections. They just want to loan out their collections. Well, many people would like to loan out the products, their collections to us because it will drive up the value of their collections. So I understand that if I know that I lack a certain piece of a collection in my catalog, and then I know someone has that item, then I would be hesitant to ask the collector to loan out the collection, because it would only drive up the value of their collection. So I welcome donation for loaning. Then, well, it would be better if we take the initiative on this. Then I welcome collectors showing us their catalog, and then we will know where to borrow it if we need a certain piece of collection. So a lot of people are donating the collections for us. Our exhibition hall 6 was supposed to be a hall for local collections. Now the waiting list is so long that people have to wait a few years before they can put the exhibits on show. So the WKCD is very near to the high-speed rail station. We want to facilitate a visitation from families, and then we will collaborate with travel agencies, and maybe we can offer a package discount, day tickets, and so on. For schools, we have similar plans. So this is just the first year. We are going to receive some 200,000 students for the first year. There will be huge demand. So for the first and second years, we will focus on local schools. And then down the road, we will look at collaborating with GBA city schools. Thank you. I remind members again, this item is supposed to end at 5:55, and we still have 8 members. So please keep your time. Mr. So Chang Wing, Chair, I won't waste time. I support the funding proposal of $240 million for Phase 1 4th construction package of the WKCD. This is crucial for the development of WKCD. We are talking about water supply, sewage, and drainage. There will be offices, hotels. So that is the infrastructure for the for such facilities. So like the chairman of the board, Mr. Henry Tang, said, these are the very pillars of the development of WKCD. So we have to complete these infrastructure. So I admired this strategy of Mr. Henry Tang's. you are not trying to compete with the livelihood items. You are not trying to compete for resources with livelihood items. So I salute you. And also, the funding proposal will cover landscaping and beautification work. It will be complementary to WKCD, and it is the soul of WKCD. So we have to make sure that the construction happens. So compared with the previous funding proposals, this amount is only minimal. So I support it.
Just now, Mr. Tang said that the land resources will be used for the funding purpose. I'd like to know more about the arrangement. Now, 4 million plus square feet of precious land can contribute to the financial balance. Now, I'm glad to see that M Plus is very popular. I hope that when WKCDA arranges for the exhibits, it will lead to an increase, a higher level of cultural appreciation, art appreciation by our public. Now, someone referred to the works by a graffiti artist, Mr. Zhang. I thank Mr. Seoul for supporting our infrastructure program. The infrastructure is necessary, and with a pier, we can relieve the burden of the land transport. Now, I thank you for your support. Now, on planning of our exhibitions, we will of course be professional and in striking a balance. Now, so everybody has to be law-abiding, and we have to be professional, and we have to be objective and balanced. Now, on the financial side, for modern art, should we help people to better understand modern culture? Now, this is an issue of education. I cannot easily explain how to appreciate modern art. Now, that is studied in universities. Now, many people normally do not appreciate modern art. I'm just talking about Zhang Zhouchoy, his graffiti. Now there's a lot of graffiti in modern art that's very expensive. Sometimes people draw graffiti, or sometimes they shred a piece of art, and that makes the art even more expensive. Now, I don't really understand that. Now, modern art and classical art, the basic difference is that if you look at ancient art, whether it's Occidental or Oriental, now, if you look at the painting, it's very pretty, It might be landscape, or still object, or a portrait. Now, classical art is for describing a beautiful world. So the porcelain, etc., they draw it so that it appears beautiful. But modern art challenges your thinking. It's not just aimed at creating beauty. It tries to stimulate thinking. So there is modern graffiti art. So if you ask me why graffiti art can represent Hong Kong art, now I can't tell you why. But I think certain people do appreciate those. So in our M+, now in our hall number one downstairs, it's all local art. We see Lap Sap Chong. We see the police recruitment posters back then. So it reminds people of Hong Kong in the old days. Of course, our approach must be law-abiding, professional, and fair and open. Judy Chen, we thank Mr. Tang for his introduction. So from his brief introduction, we know that the current achievements were hard to come by. Now, we are all concerned about the revenue, how we can get more income. Now, Mr. Tang said that he can make use of land resources only. Actually, that's not the case. Now, I absolutely support water taxi, but there is also a huge typhoon shelter. Now, recently we dealt with the Jumbo restaurant. There's a lot of scope for marine development. So perhaps the WKCD can have policy cooperation with Energizing Kowloon East or Hong Kong South to build some cooperation, come up with some cooperation on water-related projects. Now, many members of the public have an increased appreciation of art. Now, some friends, they spend 2 hours and a few thousand dollars to make a small dish. Now, I don't know whether the WKCD will nurture some handicraft that otherwise would be lost over time. For instance, the making of cheng sam, paper cutting, and so on. And also, tourism has come under a lot of difficulties during the past 2.5 years. So I hope that in our ticketing policy, there can be a bundling of admissions to different venues in some sort of hopping arrangement to revive our local tourism economy. We thank Ms. Chen for her question. Now, I wasn't trying to evade Mr. So's question on land resources. Now, on better use of land resources, I cannot spell out more details now because I'm still working things out in my mind. But I was a financial secretary. When I took over in 2003, we have over $40 billion of deficit. And then in 4 years, we ended up with $110 billion dollars of surplus. So that afforded a lot of scope for the financial secretaries after me. So I think I was a good candidate for this company that was about to go bankrupt. Now, you talked about the typhoon shelter. Now, this is a very good asset. Now, on the south, there's the WKCD, the art park. Now, on the north, it's some skyscrapers for middle-class people to live there. And on the east, it's a business district. So in the middle, it can be a sort of city harbor. But this is not under our purview. This is under the government itself. Maybe one day the government will say, well, why don't you take it over, WKCD? Now, we will be glad to do that. Then we can make the whole district appear in a very novel way. Now, we talked about the Greater Bay Area, art and cultural facilities, Macau, Guangzhou, Zhuhai. There are a lot of cultural facilities. Perhaps there can be a single pass that can allow admission to all these places. Now, but this is not yet available now, so we have to charge fees. So if you want to visit M plus fee without pay any fee, do so now, because in the future we're going to charge a fee. And we are trying to work with the LCSD to have a single pass for the government facilities. Now, for the Greater Bay Area, you have to, if you have a bundle pass, how much you're going to charge, so that visitors from abroad can buy that single pass and visit many museums, so that will offer a very rich program indeed. Sorry, I like to remind members, we all like to chat with Mr. Tang. Our time is still up. We still have six members. Now, our next item is also a public works program. So we try to stick to our time schedule of 3 minutes each. Well, we were not aware that the WKCDA would use over 30 minutes to walk us through the document. Now, so we need to make up for the time. Now, Mr. Tang asked us to have a labor union. Well, it depends on the workers, whether they would join. Now, we all heard that there isn't enough money for the WKCD. We know that this is an inherited problem. No one is blaming you. Now, right now, you are trying to compress the cost. And the workers are bearing the brunt. So this is disappointing. And there's been cutting down on community education. Now, what else can you do on getting more resources? Now, on NXB, there is an item. It says that in August 2020, the tender was withdrawn. And it said that there would be further study. Now, when would you reintroduce that? Because that would generate revenue. And then on the new pier, where $400 million are required. Now, the northern pier and the southern pier, is there a division of labor? Do they play the same roles? And for the $150 million pier, it has only one berth. Will it have its desired effect of diverting the flow of visitors? Now, when the various activities come to an end of the show and people try to leave in a hurry, and how do you offer more ways to divert them?
Betty? Yes, I will take the question and I will invite CTD to answer the question on the landing facility. So the two tendering exercises were not timely. The first one was back in August 2020. I think it was the first or second wave. So the response was not very good. We required, besides the contractors, to build a 47,000 square meters exhibition center besides hotel and office space. So we understand that under the epidemic, exhibition space has very low return. We need they need to compensate for the low return with office and hotel. So the response was very poor. So do we need an independent exhibition center as the WKCD, or whether we can integrate the developments with the Song 4 development? So that's the question. Now, since we have the phase 3 of the Exhibition and Convention Center, as well as the second phase of the AWE, the financial viability to build such a large exhibition center will not be much better than year 2020. So CDD, about the landing facility. Thank you. Now we have one berth at the southern landing facility. We have done some analysis. Every hour, there can be six vessel trips. And for each vessel, it can carry some 200 passengers. So we think one berth would be sufficient to facilitate access of vessels. This is near existing sea routes. We need to have an advanced booking mechanism to facilitate management. We will also have a northern landing facility to facilitate the development of the northern area of the WKCD. We will further discuss with the WKCDA about the future plan. Thank you. And next, Mr. Chen Yong. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Henry Tang, Mrs. Betty Feng, and Dr. Ng. Now, some quick questions. Now, like Mr. Henry Tang said, because of economic fluctuation, despite spending cuts and so on, we should let people feel the fruits of the development, then they will be more supportive. For example, can you give them some rebates or souvenirs or discounts in terms of ticketing? Then you can get more visitors. Now, media like CCTV and other TV channels have shot some great videos, and Dr. Ng has appeared in these interviews. Since these are free promotion, we should let more media do the promotion for us. In terms of management of landing facility, it is a small landing facility. If everyone comes to WKCD by sea, then it would not be sufficient. So would you charge vessels for landing and so on? So you can consider it. For my constituency, that is the engineering constituency, we are worried about cost overrunning. So would you please promise us to keep the budget tightly? It is better to have money left over rather than having to come back and ask for more money. So would you promise that you will strive to prevent a cost overrun so as to gather support from the electrical and people of and the people? Now, as Mr. Harry Tang said, if collectors are putting their exhibits, the collections for exhibits in WKCD, it is good for the value of the collections. So you should charge them. And also, you can charge for assessing the value of collections. We can create an industry to auction out collections. So like President Xi and two chief executives said, we have to have confidence in our culture. Now, in WKCDA, we see a lot of Chinese faces, including your good self. So if we engage foreign experts, well, they are only good at one thing, that is spend your money. If we engage foreign experts, it will incur much higher costs. So since we have confidence in our culture, we should do it ourselves, and you can get the support of the people. After the epidemic, the WKCD will definitely become a new landmark, and it will bring in more money. Thank you. Betty? Yes, in terms of management, we will work it out with the government. We have a priority list for public transport, like water taxi and public vessels. They will be given priority. For our own, for our vessels rented by the WKCDA for activities, they will be accorded a second priority. For private organizations, they will be given lower priority, but we welcome them. Every hour, we can accept six ships, and we also want to use the landing facility to help help the maritime industry to organize sea activities. Now, in terms of ticketing, in the past, if we give out free tickets, many visitors would not come in the end, and it would be a waste. If we would rather give out free tickets to needy people, and then if they don't come, it would be their loss, and that would be better. Mr. Tang, Mr. Chen is right. Before taking out a project, we all have the responsibility to make sure that there is no cost overrun and no delay. So the Palace Museum was planned in year 2017. At the time, the chairman was there to witness the contract signing, and in December, I was assigned board director, a board chairman by Mrs. Carrie Lam. So I have fulfilled the pledge of no overrunning and no delaying. With money left for M Plus, there would definitely be cost overrun. At the time when I took over, the contractor Sun Chong was on the brink of bankruptcy, but it was not bankrupted yet. So we can't take back the construction site. At the same time, the contractor did not pay its workers. So there were hundreds of subcontractors. All work was stopped waiting for the liquidation of Sun Chong. So we had to care for the need of the workers, and also we have to keep the schedule of M Plus opening. So we were paying the subcontractors workers directly. In the end, Sun Chong declared bankruptcy, and they exited the construction, and we took over the site, and we had to find someone to take over, and the price would definitely be higher. So that's why we are still unable to make balance. The case of Sun Chong is still being processed by court. Once the case is not closed, we can't get back the money they owe us. But I agree with what Mr. Chen said. You made a very novel suggestion. For collectors who would like to put their exhibits on show at our place, we should charge them. I think we should charge them a lot of money. So if you tell someone your piece has been exhibited in the Palace Museum, you will get $20 million extra. So I would take a half of it, let's say $10 million. So I think that's only fair. We should split it 50-50. I welcome any referral. Thank you. Mr. Benson, look, I declare that my company is running two restaurants in the WKCD. So in the past 2 years, with the global economic downturn and the epidemic, the management of WKCD can make such progress. I think this is it is extraordinary achievement. So when I ask youth groups for their opinions on today's subject, they ask me to say this to the panel. They want more internship openings. On the paper, you said you have 10 interns in M+. I know there are only so many positions, and there are 75 young people undergoing internship in the WKCDA. Besides nurturing talents for performances in terms of administration of museums, I think this is also very important that we train talents. We can only make do with what we have. So I wonder if the administration can offer dedicated funding for internship. And with Mr. Henry Tang's reputation in the business sector, I think you won't have a hard time getting sponsorships. And also, I hope there can be internship openings under the Palace Museum. In my office, we have graduates from internships in Beijing Palace Museum. So that's very good for them. So if we can offer internship placements for young people, it would be great. Well, 2 years ago, there were soft programs like a day as a curator, which we could offer to secondary school students. So I hope the administration can promise to expand, to increase the number of internship openings. Now, second question about the landing facility, I support it in principle. It is it would serve water taxis. It also reminds us that WKCD is also a tourism project. So after the opening of borders, when visitors are coming back, how much will it help the financial situation of WKCD? Mr. Tang, a brief reply. Like what I said to Mr. Chen Yong, over the past few years, what we have achieved because of the team efforts of the WKCDA, we have achieved this because of our united efforts. So I would like to put it on record that I want to give my heartfelt gratitude to the entire team of the WKCDA to have completed this. In terms of inviting sponsors, we have a dedicated team, so we can't just rely on professionals. I think if I entrusted McKinsey's to come to you and ask for money, I don't think Benson will pay heed. So we have a CEO, we have the CEO and Dr. Louis Ng. He has been very successful in terms of securing sponsorship, and also Johanna from M+, or Susanna from M+, she has also been very successful. Still, we have to launch sponsoring campaign timely, in a timely manner. We didn't grants the ACE tender because it was not timely. The bid was so low that I would only grant the tender if I was on the brink of bankruptcy. But we don't think we should sell out our resources easily because land resources is very scarce in Hong Kong. For other places, a very important avenue to raise funds is to grant the naming rights for museums. I would like to charge a reasonable sum of money for naming rights. We don't just want to sell out the naming rights for meager sums. So we'll proceed carefully and achieve a rights balance.
Now, just now, many members asked about the internship scheme. Now, for secondary schools, we have cultural ambassador arrangement, and then there's a program for restoration of artifacts. There's a program of exchanges with Beijing students, and so on. So we have a program on nurturing culture. So we can offer more information. Now, when the borders are reopened, now every time we drop our budget, we have the anticipation. So without the mainland tourists, it's a big blow because we are near the high-speed rail station. Now, we can't just rely on local residents. They might just come once only, and they won't return. So we hope that there can be two more, there are over a million visitors per year. I'd like to declare my interest. The company I work for has some ticketing cooperation with the WKCDA. Now, we see that Betty and her team have been able to save money so that the Palace Museum can open on the 1st of July without budget overrun. Now on the pier, it should be there long ago. Why was it missing in the plan? Now, you offer a 270-degree view of the harbor. You didn't even have a pier. Hong Kong's most valuable asset is the Victoria Harbour. Now, the WKCD has a long shoreline, so the lack of a pier was a great disappointment. So the construction should be stepped up. And the tourism sector is concerned about the transportation. Now, if you just rely on tour coaches, there can be traffic jams. Now, we hope that can be organization of visitors. The tourism sector can help with that. The hotels can cooperate. Now, there can be transport support arrangements. There will be a new exit road. So that's a very good plan. So there would be relief to the traffic jam. So I hope the progress can be stepped up. And on the ticketing arrangement, there can be training of tour guides. We can help with educating the visitors too. Now, Even though the chairman said that there isn't much resources for that right now, yet the tourism sector can work with the WKCDA to train the tour guides and to increase people's appreciation of culture. Now, we hope that there can soon be arrangements of for tours and for tour guides to visit, enter the premises free of charge. So I hope the WKCDA can benefit. Now, previously we talked with members about tourism. Now, this week we have meetings with tourism representatives. Now there are about 5,000 visits per day. Now, we will get some tickets for the tourism group, companies to form tour groups. Now, we have been discussing with the tourism sector about the spaces for tour coaches. They were originally in Zone 2. Now, we are now offering 23 more. Now, Austin Road West, there are 10 additional parking spaces for the tour coaches to park there while they wait for their passengers, and they can then pick them up at the Palace Museum. When we charge for M Plus, then we can offer joint tickets for so that visitors, visiting tours from the GBA can come here. Next, Mr. Andrew Lam. Now about the pier. Now I will volunteer an answer for Mr. Yu Park Leung's question. Now it was in the plan, but there were many restrictions back then. But I very much welcome this concept. Now I was going to ask about the land resources. Maybe I can direct that question to the secretary instead of Mr. Tang. Now, given the current environment, is it that the Home Affairs Bureau should give full support to the WKCD and review the planning of the lands, the sites for commercial use, because in the long run, we can't just rely on operational revenue, and that applies not just to the WKCD. Now, from the planning side, can you change your some of your plans to now? Back then, some people obstructed the WKCDA, and then they worked for the URA, and then they... So things can change. We thank Mr. Lam for his question, and we thank him for his support of the PIER project. Now, on the review of land resources, just now Mr. Tang explained and succinctly in detail the scope. Now, given his leadership, the WKCDA will develop ever better, have a better future. The SCL government will also do a lot of work, which we will disclose at the right time. Once again, we thank the WKCDA and the Home Affairs Bureau for attending. We have 15 members asking questions. This is a good interchange, although time was rather tight. So this is the first meeting in the new term. So everyone is concerned about the WKCD development. Maybe we hope that you can come back and brief us in the future. Now, there's an item on of discussion. Do we not are we agreeable that this item be forwarded to the Public Works Subcommittee? Good. Now, we hope that in July we can visit the Palace Museum. Now, we have another item of agenda. Now, I'd like to extend the meeting by 15 minutes. Because this work is also a works item that goes to PWSC. So we can invite the officials to join us. We hope that the administration could brief us very succinctly, and then we'll see whether there are questions from members. Now, this document is about two improvement of district infrastructure. Both involve the $8 billion for district improvements in the 18 to 19 budget. One involves Moores Park in Wong Tai Sin, and the other involves a lift tower and pedestrian footbridge in Kwai Chung. Now, the document is very, very exhaustive. I'd just like to say that both projects are urgently anticipated by the residents of Wong Tai Sin and Kwai Cheng District. Now, this will especially benefit those who have mobility problems. So we hope that members can support this so that it can this item can go quickly to PWSC and Finance Committee so that the works can commence quickly. Not many members have pressed the button, only four, 3 minutes. Leung Chi Weng. Now, I'm not a member of this panel. Now, I was a district council member of Kwai Cheng in 2008-09. This item was discussed in Kwai Cheng District Council. I support this both items. Now, the footbridge between Moores Park three and four. Now, many of our facilities separated. This project will allow people with mobility difficulties to go to more sites in parks. Now, the document says that previously there was some objection, but the government offered explanations and the objections were withdrawn. So the government did a lot of work on that. And I hope that the Kwai Cheng project can be implemented quickly, because Kwai Cheng is rather unusual. Housing developments were built on hillsides. Now, the slopes sometimes were quite steep. Shek Lei Estate 1 and 2. Now, within housing department, they offer escalators and lifts, offering a lot of help for access by people with mobility difficulties. But when residents want to go down to Wai Hap Road, it's quite difficult because the Wai Hap Road is very busy. There are buses and minibuses which stop at the housing development. So in the past, many residents have to walk up the hillside from Wai Hap Road. So this project will help elderly people and people with access difficulties. So now they can take the lift connect with Tai Lung Street. So this is environmentally very friendly.
It will open up more developments in the community, and also it will facilitate access of the residents to other facilities like basketball courts and so on. And also we have the Mapley Hose Center down at Wai Hap Road to facilitate access to the center as well. So I hope members will support the program. So I thank Mr. Leung for your support. You have pointed out the benefits of the two projects. These projects are on the slope, and for elderly people and people with accessibility issues, it would help them. Thank you. Mr. Jovi Chen, I declare that I have been on the Rehabilitation Advisory Committee for 6 years, help enhance the accessibility in Hong Kong. So I support the project. At Wai Hap Road, we have a very long staircase with the construction of a footbridge. We can facilitate access for elderly people. They don't have to take the stairs anymore, so I support it. The paper says the projects will be completed in 3 years, and with proper consultation, you will carry out noise mitigation measures during the construction. There are schools near the site, so I think that would be very good with noise mitigation measures. So recently I visited the neighborhood. This photo shows that the railings are rusty. This is the M423. It is the Thai Wall interchange near Kwai Chung. In year 2018, in October, the policy address has included this location in the Universal Accessibility Program. In year 2022, we have the design. I thank Ken, the district officer of Kwai Chung District, who responded to my inquiry swiftly. In January 2023, the project will commence and it will be completed by year 2026. It took 8 years' time from announcements to completion, so I'm worried about the progress of this project. Even if we approve the, even if we give green lights to the program, will there be any delays? And do we have a punishment mechanism if there is any delay? I think the improvement of accessibility facilities would be supported by all members. So I only want a clear answer about the progress of the project. I thank Ms. Chen for supporting the programs. We will complete the programs as soon as possible. They are very beneficial for local residents. At Kwai Chung, the gradient is 1 to 12. We have 80 steps of stairs, and it is 50 meters long. So for elderly people and people difficult with mobility issues, it would be it is very difficult for them. So we will speed it up by tendering the project simultaneously. So subject to your support and the finance committee's funding approval, we can start work immediately. Next, Ms. Maggie Chan. Thank you, Chair. I'm talking about the Moores Park project. I declare that when I was a Wong Tai Sin District Council member, there I was involved in a discussion of the project. I have been a four-term Wong Tai Sin District Councillor, and I have been living in Wong Tai Sin for some 20 years. I understand the difficulty of access of residents to number 3 and 4 at Moss Park. So this program has been something that local residents have been urging for a long time. So finally it has reached the electrical. I support the project. It will provide a lot of convenience to Wong Tai Sin residents, especially people with mobility issues and elderly people. So about this project, it will align the layout of Moss Park and create a synergy to better serve Wong Tai Sin residents. So I totally support it. But we have to pay attention to the layout of Moss Park for there are Chinese Lunar New Year market in Moss Park, and also there are performances in the plaza. So I hope there can be more signages as put up in Moss Park to give people direction. So signages are very important. It will be beneficial for large-scale activities after the pandemic, and it will enhance the function of the footbridge. Response from the administration. I thank Ms. Chen for your support, and I thank Ms. Chen for your reminders. They are very important. After all, phase 1 to 4 of Moss Park are of large scales. They are sizable. Now we are connecting Park 3 and 4 and the at grade park to enhance accessibility. So signages are very important. Since the park is so huge, we don't want people to get lost. So we will enhance the signages. Thank you. Next, Mr. Chen Yong. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Secretary and Commissioners and the engineers. This is a livelihood project. We support them. It will benefit local residents, especially children, elderly people, and families. So we support it in principle. So this is a relatively small-scale project. In my constituency, the opinion is that the cost for a footbridge is so huge, especially under the current economic circumstances. It costs as high as $100 million. So the project is very important. If you can build it at a more reasonable cost, it would be even better. For public works projects, it is often that we have cost overrun. So can you try and promise that there will not be a cost overrun? Otherwise, people would think that there will always be a cost overrun, and it would be you would face more opposition when you propose future projects. So thank you. Thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Chen Yong, for your support. We will definitely control the cost to make sure that it is up to standard as the lowest cost possible. In terms of cost overrun, please do not worry. Tender has been put out already, so the figure is the actual figure. Subject to the support of this panel, we will submit the projects the proposals to PWSC and the FC. Ms. Darley, thank you. I'm not a member of this panel, but I come here to support these projects. As a councillor from the Kowloon Central constituency, this is very important for the neighbourhood. I thank the commissioner for your hard work in securing support for this project. For those living in Wong Tai Sin, We all know that there are a lot of slopes, but that's also true for a lot of districts. We really need pedestrian linkages. It has been on discussion for a long time in the district. So we are concerned about whether the project can be completed in time and whether it can be kept within budget, because after all, it is public money. So we want to see the project commenced as soon as possible. And also during the project, I hope you can continue to listen to the district's voice. Now, in terms of universal accessibility programs and pedestrian footbridges, they are well received by elderly people, especially by residents, especially elderly people. So for Wong Tai Sin district, they are much needed, but it is also true for other districts. So I hope the new term of the government can roll out a new round of the universal accessibility program. Our society is aging. We need more footbridges. Thank you. Secretary, thank you, Chair, and thank you, Mr. Lee, for your support. We will speed up the progress. For other projects, as long as they are livelihood programs which are beneficial for people's life, and we will make sure they happen. Now it's my turn. I give my support to both projects. A lot of residents, especially elderly people, need the footbridges. I applaud the Wong Tai Sin District Council members for bringing it to our attention. So I hope the project can start soon. For Moores Park, I want to talk about the swimming pool. It has been completed for a while, since the other swimming pool in the neighborhood is closed. I hope the swimming pool can be completed as soon as possible. So that's all. So any other questions concerning this item, then if there are no objections, we support submitting this paper for PWSC's consideration. No objections. If that's the case, then the item is completed. Finally, AOB. If there is no AOB, then the meeting is adjourned. Thank you.